speak of Nelson Mandela, in mortal terms, is trying to eclipse the shadow of a person who showed that it was easier to rebuild a nation using love and peace rather than hate and war. South Africans are making the first Mandela Day since their former president's death passed away on December 5, 2013. In November 2009, the United Nations declared July 18th as Nelson Mandela Day. Mandela, the country's first black president and anti-apartheid icon, spent 27 years in prison and eventually led South Africa to democracy. He was among the first to advocate armed resistance to apartheid in 1960, but was quick to preach reconciliation and forgiveness when the country's white minority began easing its grip on power 30 years later. Mandela retired from public life in 2004 and stepped out of the spotlight, spending much of his time with family in his childhood village. Mandela was buried in Kunu in the Eastern Cape. The casket lay in state of 3 days for public viewing. Nelson Mandela was born on July 18, 1918 in Mweso, Transkei, South Africa. Becoming actively involved in the anti-apartheid movement in his 20s, Mandela joined the African National Congress in 1942. For 20 years, he directed a campaign of peaceful, non-violence and defense against the South African government and its racist policies. In 1993, Mandela and South African President Klerk were jointly awarded the Nobel Peace Prize for their efforts to dismantle the country's apartheid system. Mandela was inducted as South Africa's first black president. In 2009, Mandela's birthday, July 18th, was declared Mandela Day to prompt global peace and celebrate the South African leader's legacy. Mandela died at his home in Johannesburg on December 5, 2013 at the age of 95. Mandela was baptized in the Methodist Church. He went on to become the first in his family to attend school. Mandela has constantly proclaimed his commitment to Christ as his Lord throughout his adult life. His fight against racial inequality as well as leadership in reconciling the white South Africans. Afrikaners with the black South Africans have reflected the ideas of Christian principles of justice, forgiveness and reconciliation, forming the bedrock for his political and social motivations. While working as a lawyer, Mandela was repeatedly arrested for seditious activities and tried for high treason in December 1956, but was found not guilty. Although initially committed to non-violent protests, he co-founded the militant VCC in 1961, leading a bomb campaign against government targets. He was jailed for 5 years in November 1962 and was sentenced to life imprisonment on June 12, 1964. Mandela was released unconditionally from prison on February 11, 1990. After 27 years of imprisonment, first on Robben Island and later in Holsmoor Prison and Victor Verster Prison, he was 71. While in prison, he suffered lung damage while working in a prison quarry. He also contracted tuberculosis in 1980s. As I walked out the door toward the gate that would lead to my freedom, I knew if I didn't leave my bitterness and hatred behind, I would still be in prison, recalled Mandela, whose radical change in mindset would affect how he deal with his opponents. In 1993, Mandela was granted the Nobel Peace Prize for his resistance against the ruling national party's apartheid policies and for his efforts to establish non-racial democracy in South Africa. Mandela was famously quoted, "One of the things I learned when I was negotiating was that until I changed myself, I could not change others." Nelson Mandela made his last public appearance to date in 2010 at the final match of the World Cup in South Africa. He is survived by his third wife, Gara Michael, whom he married in 1998. In 1988, on his 80th birthday,